Hi everyone, welcome to Irfan CFPS YouTube channel. Just to remind our new viewers, we have started an FPA 13 course to help you feel confident and get expertise in design and installation of automatic sprinkler systems. In our last class, we have reviewed the overall concept of preaction systems and their types as defined by an FPA 13. In today's class, we shall go through the types of preaction systems once again as a revision and discuss the system operation for single interlock in detail, considering electric and pneumatic release systems using schematic diagrams. If this is the first time you are visiting my channel, make sure to hit the subscription button below and click the notification icon to get the updates on our courses related to fire protection systems. An FPA 13 defines three basic types of preaction systems. Number one, single interlock type. Number two, non-interlock type. And number three, double interlock type preaction systems. Single interlock preaction systems admits water to sprinkler piping upon operation of detection devices only. Detection systems may be electric or pneumatic. Non-interlock preaction systems admits water to sprinkler piping upon either operation of detection devices or automatic sprinklers. Double interlock preaction systems admits water to sprinkler piping upon operation of both the detection devices and automatic sprinklers. Let's see single interlock preaction system with electric release. The schematic shown on your screen is electrically controlled single interlock preaction system. Before we move further, let us have a look on the main system components for this type. As you can see on your screen, the main components are releasing control panel, detector, deluge valve with complete trim assembly, solenoid valve which is normally closed, system piping which is connected to the sprinklers, pressure operated relief valve. Apart from these components, there are various other components such as air compressors, check valves, butterfly valves, restricted orifice, alarm bell, pressure switches. All these are required for proper functioning of the system. Electric release systems utilize a deluge valve and a pneumatically pressurized automatic sprinkler system. Unlike dry type, the system piping here is pressurized only for supervisory purposes. This feature serves to prevent undetected leaks. If the system piping or sprinklers are damaged, supervisory pressure is reduced and a low air alarm is activated in the panel. As we know that the main purpose of preaction system is to not to allow the water to discharge in no fire condition. If the system is not supervised, we will not know whether there are any leaks or pipes are damaged. Let us understand the concept of electric release systems. Electrical release systems required an electric solenoid. This valve is controlled by an approved releasing control panel with compatible detection system. In fire condition, when the detection system operates, the system control panel energizes the solenoid valve to open, causing the deluge valve to open. The sprinkler system fills with water. If any sprinklers have opened, water will flow from the system. If sprinklers have not opened, water will be in the sprinkler system piping only. A sprinkler head must open before water flows from the system. Let us discuss the system operation in detail by using a schematic diagram. In the set condition, the system water supply pressure enters the priming chamber of the deluge valve through a 1/4 inch line, which includes a normally open priming valve, strainer, restricted orifice, and a check valve. As we can see in the figure, this line is also connected to the normally closed solenoid valve and also to the emergency release button. In the set condition, water supply pressure is trapped in the priming chamber by the check valve and normally closed solenoid valve. The pressure in the priming chamber holds the deluge valve clapper closed, keeping the outlet chamber and the system pipe dry. In fire condition, when the detection system operates, the system control panel activates an alarm and energizes the normally closed solenoid valve to open. Pressure is released from the priming chamber and flows to the solenoid valve to the open drain cup faster than it is supplied through the restricted orifice to the deluge valve. Once the release valve clapper opens, allows water to flow into the system piping and alarm devices, causing the water motor alarm and water flow alarms connected to the alarm pressure switch to activate. When a sprinkler head opens, water will flow from the sprinklers. When the deluge valve operates, the sensing end of the PORV, which is a pressure operated relief valve, is pressurized, causing the PORV to operate. When the PORV operates, it continually vents the priming chamber to prevent the deluge valve from resetting in case of fire. The deluge valve can only be reset after the system has been taken out of service and the outlet chamber of the deluge valve and this complete associated trim piping are depressurized and drained. For example, if any of the sprinklers opens prior to the operation of the detection system or any time supervisory pressure in this sprinkler piping is lost, the air supervisory switch E3 will signal a low air pressure condition in the releasing control panel, but the deluge valve will not open. For example, in case if the detection system operates due to a mechanical damage or malfunction, the deluge valve will open, but the water will be contained in the sprinkler piping until and unless the sprinklers are being activated. The water motor alarm and alarms connected to the alarm pressure switches will activate. In order to operate this preaction system manually, then there is an emergency release, as you can see on this schematic diagram. Anytime the handle inside this emergency release is pulled, pressure is released from the priming chamber and water flows through this emergency release and the deluge valve will open. Water will flow into the system piping and alarm devices will be activated. If a sprinkler head opens, water will flow from the system. Now let us discuss pneumatic release type single interlock preaction system. The concept is same as electric release type. We have seen in our earlier slide, for electric release systems to operate, there will be a dedicated releasing control panel with compatible detection system or detectors. Once the detector activates, it gives signal to the releasing control panel, thereby energizing the solenoid valve, which is normally closed, to open. Once the solenoid valve will open, the water in the priming chamber releases and flows to the solenoid valve to the drain. As the pressure difference is created, water will flow through the deluge valve to the complete system piping. Upon activation of sprinklers, the water will flow out of the piping network. However, in pneumatic release type systems, there will not be any kind of releasing control panel or smoke or heat detectors. Before we proceed ahead to understand the system operation for this type, let us have a look at the system components. As we can see from the screen, the main components include pilot head, fixed temperature release, or thermostatic release. This acts as detection system. And other components like butterfly valve, check valve, deluge valve, air compressor, pressure switches, pressure gauges, everything are same. However, there will be a pneumatic actuator which is normally closed since the detection system is pneumatic type. Pilot head and fixed temperature releases are the closed type of sprinklers. However, thermostatic release opens to allow pressure in the release system to escape. As we can see from this schematic, air compressor piping is connected to the system piping for pressurizing, and also this network is connected to the pneumatic detection system. In fire condition, operation of the pneumatic release system opens the deluge valve to fill the system with water. If any sprinklers have opened, water will flow from the system. If sprinklers have not opened, water will remain in the sprinkler system piping until the system operates. A sprinkler head must open before water flows from the system. I hope you enjoyed our class. In next class, we shall learn about non-interlock preaction systems. Thanks for watching my YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe to learn more on fire protection system. and make sure to hit the subscription button below and click on the notification to get the updates.